I'm Vince Weston, and I finally made it. I guess this has been about 6 months I've been working on this, but I finally finished the Williams Brothers Pitcairn Autogiro. Excuse me, I'm a little winded. Which I based it on this drawing, and as I told you in the intro, I wanted to eventually maybe build a diorama like this for it, but that'll have to come later. Anyway, there she is. Let me see if I can get a little closer. Wrong button. Okay. The fun part, of course, was, since this is a craftsman kit, is doing most of the detail work. From my last video update on this one, you saw that I had pretty much everything done, except for the rigging, which is on the tail and across the wings and down underneath, and also the windscreens had to be made out of a sheet of, it's almost acetate but a little softer, and then the rigging for the it's not the propeller, rotor, that's the word I'm looking for. There's a square goes this way, and then there's supports that go across the center with bungee cords coming up, and that's about as close as I can get anyway. So that's what I've been working on all this time. Just as a quick aside, if you notice the windscreens, I didn't paint that. Actually, I used this. It's Charpak graphic tape. It's real thin. I think it's 1/32, and I use that to make the frames on the windscreens. I'll give her a little spin. The rigging is mostly monofilament and some wire in some of the other spaces. And I discovered something, that my hair dryer will actually shrink monofilament, so I was able to get it tight. I'm sure in this light you're probably not going to see most of it. Underneath, there's rigging goes across and up, and then there's an X in the back, and there's rigging along the wings for support, and then of course on the rotor. And let's see, what else took me forever? On the tail, there's rigging goes around, and then I have Erelon, I'm sure I'm saying that wrong, risers underneath for the flaps and the rotor, rudder. And self-made decals. The number was kind of meant to match the photograph. So, there she is in all of her glory. Oh, also, I did imitate, there are turnbuckles in the midst of the rotor here, and I did that with a little super glue and some black paint so that it'll show. In flight, those turnbuckles pushed the out and helped the rotor rise, as you can see in the background picture, where the rotor is up as opposed to down in a landing position. Let's see what other exciting things have happened. That's pretty much all of it. So I hope you enjoyed it. It was a fun kit, even though it was a lot of work. I did enjoy it. And I know most of this is not showing up on the camera anyway. So, oh, by the way, in the front cockpit I did put a clock and an altimeter by hand painting, which of course you wouldn't be able to see from your position, but the front is here, the pilot sits here. Oops, my big fat fingers are in the way. Oops. This is the front seat where passengers would ride, and that's the cockpit back here. Oops, I guess I should turn that a little so you can see me. Where the pilot would be. Okay, that's about the size of it. Time to start this baby up and see how she flies. Have fun. I'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. Long journeys wear me out. Oh God, you know.